Hey guys, it's
Liminal.
Today we are coming at you with another video, just a short one today, and we'll be reacting to Wind of Change by Scorpions, which I don't think you've heard before.
I don't think so.
Hopefully not. We'll see what she thinks.
The whistling mimics the wind.
Pardon?
The whistling mimics the wind.
So there's Wind of Change. What do you think?
It was really good. It wasn't what I expected.
What did you think it would be?
I thought it would be more rock.
Yeah, I mean, this is considered a rock song, I guess. But it's not, like, heavy, I guess, in that sense.
It's not heavy.
Yeah. Is that a good thing to you or bad?
It's good because I saw Scorpion and I was like, yeah, it's probably going to be pretty hardcore.
Yeah.
And then in the end it was like really chill and nice. I think it matches the weather now perfectly.
Yeah, we like our rainy day kind of songs, and I feel like the vibe of it is very, like, as much as it is an anthem, and we'll go into that a bit later, it's very like chill, and I feel like it does match the rainy weather with the whistles and the
and
wind.
And the whistling, I felt like when I heard it, I thought, yeah, it resembles the wind.
Mm-hmm. like the whistles carrying along the wind. Yeah, so I was listening to this podcast on Spotify, and if we see it here, there's actually a conspiracy theory that the CIA wrote it, and it was because it came like a Cold War anthem, and it caused civil unrest and stuff. And you know how the US was putting a lot of propaganda and all that kind of thing during the Cold War. So there's actually a conspiracy theory that that is what Wind of Change is.
That is very interesting.
Yeah, so I guess it's played a really large part in culture and history as well as like an anthem of the Cold War. Yeah, so Soviet officials had long been nervous over the free expression that rock stood for and how it might affect the Soviet youth. The CIA saw rock music as a cultural weapon in the Cold War. So that's a really interesting notion of music as a cultural weapon. Yeah.
I think we can actually delve into this in a podcast, in a future podcast. Oh, that's so
true. Music as like a cultural weapon. I mean, if you want to look at the lyrics, they actually wrote it, I think, after they were in Russia. So they're talking about taking a walk through Moscow in the start. And like a lot of people are like, what is that? But I guess to Russia, it's something really familiar, which is why people are like, ooh, this is interesting. Because at the same time, what you said about rock as well and the Scorpions, like, you know, previously they know, but here I am, rock you like a hurricane. And then they come out with this and it kind of seems weird, right?
Yeah, it does. Yeah. It's more like a ballad.
Yeah, so I guess that kind of is in line with what we were talking about with that. And then, you know, an August summer night, soldiers passing by, listening to the wind of change. And this wind of change, I feel like that's a really powerful idea as well. Like, you're feeling the change in the air.
Mm-hmm.
So it's interesting how that...
It's all around you.
Yeah. The future's in the air. I can feel it everywhere, blowing with the wind
music,
of change.
And music, and you know how they talk... We're talking about music as a cultural weapon. Mm-hmm. I reckon that's also because when you listen to music, a lot of people just don't listen to the lyrics themselves.
Mm.
And like... The same, and if you like the song, it just keeps getting ingrained in your head subconsciously. Yeah, there's
this notion of like earworms, and this is one of them with the whistling, like do 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 do, and like the wind of change is really catchy. I guess it's like this weird subconscious thing that it really enters and burrows its way into your mind, and messages can really get to you that way without you even noticing sometimes. Yeah. Yeah, so I feel like
that's really cool.
It's actually a really cool song. Would you add it to your playlist?
Yeah.
Yes, add it to your rainy day playlist. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I don't know. It's got a really cool cultural history, and I feel like it opened up quite an interesting discussion.
Yeah.
So let us know what you guys think in the comments down below. We'd really love to hear your thoughts. Do you think the CIA wrote Wind of Change? I'd be interested to know. Anyway, until next time, guys, please don't be afraid to like,
subscribe,
and comment down below. We'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!